Good evening, everyone, on Out Late But Great. It's Colette, your host for Sundays. I'm going to try to make this video without any interruptions, but I think there's a cat outside that is driving my dogs crazy. So I'm really sorry if there's tons of barking in this video. This week's topic was one that I came up with talking about the death of Leelah Alcorn, who was a transgender girl who took her life a few weeks ago in Ohio. And I basically wanted to ask the panel how they handle depression, feelings of hopelessness, and what they wouldn't mind sharing with our viewers. And a bonus question is, what are you looking forward to most in 2015? Now, first of all, why I asked that bonus question is also to brighten the mood, but also it's how I get through my depression and my feelings of hopelessness is focusing on things that I look forward to, even if it's just something simple like I'm going to have French fries for dinner. I know that sounds kind of simple, but there's some things like that that you just makes you forget about why you were even upset in the first place. But first of all, like, the death of Leelah really upset me a lot because when I read her suicide letter, I really related a lot to her story. And then hearing like how her parents treated her and all those things like that, I couldn't imagine coming out and telling my parents at the age that she did. And I'm almost 100% sure the reaction would have been similar to what happened to her. There was a similar situation with my parents when they found pictures of me in drag, and it didn't really go over well in my family. And the look that they gave me of disapproving and disgust is something that I think to this day has still traumatized me. So I couldn't imagine what she was living with, especially since her parents knew her truth and treated her that way. With that said, you know, there's one thing that I can say that I feel like has contributed to my success thus far in my transition is when I got away from the people that were oppressing me in my life, I was able to forge my own life and to forge people around me that were a great support system. And this took a really long time, and it was extremely overwhelming, and it's just hard work to leave everything you've ever known and to try to create a new life. And luckily, I was smart with the people that I did make friends with, because when I told them my truth, they didn't run away screaming. We've actually become much closer. And that's something that I can say, like, I have to thank all my friends and my who I consider my family, who have been there for me. Because if it wasn't for them, I don't know where I would be. I honestly don't know. And that's the thing that really upset me about Leelah, is I feel like she didn't have anyone. And that's a big reason why I do YouTube. I do YouTube, it's because I don't even know what I can do to help people not take their life, but even if it's just seeing someone live their life as a trans person or an LGBT person, hey, it might help someone. I don't really know. And since I've been transitioning the past 5 years, I've known a handful of girls that have taken their life, two of which I used to watch here on YouTube regularly. And those tasks were, I don't know. See, it's interesting because when I told my one boss about my true self, and she asked me a lot about suicide, because we talked about Leelah, and that's who I said was my inspiration to actually finally bite the bullet and come out. And she wanted to know why someone would take their life. And it was a lot of stuff that I told her, you know, I don't really know. And there's a lot of reasons. I mean, it's not only do you have the stress of your daily living, but you also have the stress of something else going on inside of you. And if no one knows about it, if they know about it, and if how you're treated, I mean, it's just can be all-encompassing. So it was just, I don't know. I'm kind of not really making sense. I hope I am. But how I handle those feelings and how I handle feeling hopeless is just little things that pull me out of it. And it could be watching like comedians on YouTube like Joan Rivers or Sarah Silverman, people that offend, and just kind of, I laugh at it. Whatchamacallit, my animals, like, there's a little fuzzy kitty. Oh, she's under the covers. That brightens my day. Those things, my animals, I have to thank too, because they always, always make me laugh. And That's honestly what helps me, is my animals, my boyfriend, my friends, those little things that remind me of why I'm here. And if I do anything to remove myself, I will leave a void. And I guess knowing that now, I feel like I can't. I have to push through my sadness sometimes. And lately, I've been feeling a lot of crushing blows of hopelessness. And it's just, you know, I think it's like getting to that point of coming out to everyone, especially in my professional life. And like the second manager I told didn't go as well as the first manager I told. So leaving work for the weekend feeling uneasy wasn't something to set well. And I would think a lot about other trans people that have been through this and how they managed to do it. And I have so much more respect. I have way more respect for people who've gone before me, because even though mine, I feel like, isn't as intense, it's those people that pave the way and those people who are visible that help me realize that it's going to be okay. So yeah, I hope that answers the question. And what am I looking forward to? What I'm looking forward to in 2015 is, well, I'm a huge Madonna fan. And Madonna is releasing a new album in March, March 10th. And she released 6 tracks at Christmas time, so I was shrieking and going crazy. And I freaking love all of the 6 tracks. And I can't wait for the rest of the album. And I'm praying that she goes on tour. And I pray that it will be before my surgery date for my SRS surgery so I can see her. I've already seen her twice, so I love to see her again. I'm also having SRS surgery, so I'm looking forward to that at the end of the year. I'm looking forward to working on my house because my house is a little fixer-upper. So I have lots of little projects to do. And I'm really looking forward to coming out and living my life full-time at work. And I'm already living it in my personal life, so I'm excited to take that on, even though it is very overwhelming. And I look forward to seeing all of you every week. And yeah, so I'm going to sign off for now. If you have any comments, feel free to leave them below. You have a safe and fabulous week, everyone, and I will check in with you next week. Bye.